Hello, and welcome to the Blessed Sacrament Chapel here at Holy Cross Church in Porterville, California. Today we celebrate the Saturday in the 25th week in Ordinary Time. Our celebrant is our pastor, Monsignor Scott Doherty. All the richest of the people long to see your face. Behind her, her maiden companions are escorted to the king. Her attendants are escorted to you amid gladness and joy.
May the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
As we prepare for this time of prayer and this Holy Mass, and as we honor the Blessed Virgin Mary, we pray for the grace and peace of God our Father, and we pray for the grace of perseverance. You were sent to heal the contrite of heart, Kyrie eleison. You came to call sinners, Christe eleison. You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us, Kyrie eleison. Almighty God, have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. O God, who chose the Blessed Virgin Mary foremost among the poor and humble, to be the mother of the Savior, grant, we pray, that, following her example, we may offer you the homage of sincere faith and place in you all our hope of salvation, through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen. A reading from the book of Ecclesiastes. Rejoice, O young man, while you are young, and let your heart be glad in the days of your youth. Follow the ways of your heart, the vision of your eyes, yet understand that as regards all this, God will bring you to judgment. Ward off grief from your heart and put away trouble from your presence. Though the dawn of youth is fleeting, remember your Creator in the days of your youth, before the evil days come and the years approach of which you will say, I have no pleasure in them. Before the sun is darkened, and the light and the moon and the stars, while the clouds return after the rain, and the strong men are bent, and the grinders are idle because they are few, and they who look through the windows grow blind, when the doors to the street are shut, and the sound of the mill is low, when one waits for the chirp of a bird. But all the daughters of song are suppressed, and one fears heights and perils in the streets, when the almond tree blossoms and the locust grows sluggish, and the caperberry is without effect, because man goes to his lasting home, and mourners go about the streets, before the silver cord is snapped, and the golden bowl is broken, and the pitcher is shattered at the spring, and the broken pulley falls into the well, and the dust returns to the earth as it once was, and the life breath returns to God who gave it. Vanity of vanities, says Qoheleth, all things are vanity. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The responsorial psalm. In every age, O Lord, you have been our refuge.
In every age, O Lord, you have been our refuge.
You turn man back to dust, saying, return, O children of men. For 1,000 years in your sight are as yesterday, now that it is past, or as a watch of the night.
In every age, O Lord, you have been our refuge.
You make an end of them in their sleep. The next morning they are like the changing grass, which at dawn springs up anew, but by evening wilts and fades.
In every age, O Lord, you have been our refuge.
Teach us to number our days aright, that we may gain wisdom of heart. Return, O Lord, how long? Have pity on your servants.
In every age, O Lord, you have been our refuge.
Fill us at daybreak with your kindness, that we may shout for joy and gladness all our days. And may the gracious care of the Lord, our God, be ours. Prosper the work of our hands for us. Prosper the work of our hands.
In every age, O Lord, you have been our refuge.
Alleluia, 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 alleluia.
Our Savior, Christ Jesus, destroyed death and brought life to light through the gospel.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
With your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
While they were all amazed at his every deed, Jesus said to his disciples, pay attention to what I'm telling you. The Son of Man is to be handed over to men. But they did not understand this saying. Its meaning was hidden from them, so that they should not understand it. And they were afraid to ask him about this saying. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Ecclesiastes reminds us of how fleeting this life is, that we are only on this mortal plane for a brief time, and yet often we hang on to this time as if it were the only time, as if we had no vision for anything more. As if we had no knowledge, or appreciation, or desire to know, love, and serve God. It is a challenging reality, but in this life, our God has given us so many signs to point us in the direction of the kingdom. Yes, there are great evils in this world, and have always been. But at the same time, there's great goodness There's holy saints. In the darkest times in human history, the greatest saints have arisen. All of us are called to be saints. All of us are called to see with the eyes of faith and recognize the thin veil that separates us from the kingdom. But if we remain in darkness, closed off, if we remain in the grip of fear and faithlessness, if we remain in the grip of materialism and just what this world offers, then we will be hard-pressed to see the way open before us to the kingdom. Our Lord does not promise us an easy life. The faith, our Judeo-Christian heritage, is not about everything going great in this world. Anyone who's studied the Old Testament, the Hebrew Scriptures, understands this. Anyone who knows 20th century history and now 21st century history knows this. The Shoah, that great, horrible murder of so many during the regime of the Nazis in Germany, was an attempt to completely wipe out Judaism, completely wipe out the root foundation of Christianity. And the other goal for them was to transform society into a secular image of the Nazi party. They had established their own religious rituals, in a sense. They had no desire to honor Christianity, to honor Christ. They did their worst, and they failed. And in the midst of the Shoah, in the midst of the horrible darkness of that time in history, great saints arose. The faith was not destroyed. Our Judeo-Christian heritage remains intact, strong, defended by so many who embrace that faith heroically in Jewish tradition and Christian tradition, knowing that we are not bound to this mortal plane, but we are children of God, bound to the kingdom prepared for us by our Savior, to that banqueting table that awaits us. The disciples, they had a lot of questions, but there was a time and a place for their questions, for the answers to their questions. And though Jesus gave them so many answers, the understanding of those answers was not necessarily in the moment when the words were spoken. They came later as everything unfolded in the life of Christ, in the early life of the church. The reality is that life continues to unfold. And as it does unfold, we know that we are not alone, that we do not anchor ourselves to the promises of this world, but are children of God, children prepared for the banqueting table in the kingdom. It was difficult for the disciples to understand at the time, but they came to understand. And with them throughout it all was Mary, Jesus' mother, the mother of Jesus, therefore the mother of God, therefore the mother of the church. She was there as a stabilizing figure in their midst. She was there in the upper room of Pentecost when the Holy Spirit came upon them and the birth of the church was made manifest. Mary is still with us, and we honor her today because she is our spiritual mother. She's the mother of the church. And with her, we pray now and daily, let God's will be done in my life so that I might see with the eyes of faith and keep my focus on the kingdom of heaven. God's ways are high above ours, and so we turn to him and pray for the purification, sanctification, and continuing conversion of Pope Francis, Pope Emeritus Benedict, Bishop Joseph Brennan, Bishop Emeritus Armando Ochoa, all clergy and religious. We pray to the Lord.
Hear us, O Lord.
For the defeat of the coronavirus pandemic, and for the healing of all who are afflicted by the virus, for all who suffer because of fires afflicting California and the western states, and for the relief for all who suffer, we pray to the Lord.
Hear us, O Lord.
For peace in our nation, that all racism, hatred, division, vengeance cease. Let your spirit renew the face of the earth and the hearts and minds of all your children. We pray to the Lord.
Hear us, O Lord.
For the intention of this Mass, in memory of Betty Wilder, we pray to the Lord.
Hear us, O Lord.
For all who have died, for victims of war and violence, sons and daughters, brothers and sisters, fallen in military service, victims of abortion, and for all those who have recently died, Peter Chavez, infant Jesus Hernandez, Felix Martinez, Julie Peralta, Justice Ruth Bader Ginsburg, we pray to the Lord.
Hear us, O Lord.
For the sick, especially those fallen ill due to the coronavirus, for victims of oppression, hatred, war, violence, especially the violence and sexual exploitation and assault, that they may be blessed with the fullness of health in body, mind, and soul, please keep in your prayers Monsignor John Coelho Hargandiggy, Monsignor John Esquivel, Monsignor Ron Royer, Father Angel Sotelo, Father Roberto Saldivar Ureño, Linda Barron, Maria Cortez, Roxana Guerrero, Connie Markman, Phil LaMonaco, Carlos Lopez, Judy Ramirez, Martha Schott, Jan Wheelock, Manuela Alvarado, we pray to the Lord.
Hear us, Lord.
For the protection of law enforcement officers, persons in the military, firefighters, providers of medical services, that they serve with honor and courage and return home in good health, in body, mind, and soul, we pray to the Lord.
Hear us, O Lord.
For faithful Christ-centered priests to serve God's people and preside at his holy altars, we pray to the Lord.
Hear us, O Lord.
For rain and snow to nourish our lands and lives, we pray to the Lord.
Hear us, O Lord.
For their freedom to gather unfettered in our churches, we pray to the Lord.
Hear us, O Lord.
For our personal intentions, which we include in a moment of silent prayer. For these needs, we pray to the Lord.
Hear us, O Lord.
Generous God, hear our prayers and grant what the Spirit bids us ask in the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands, it will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Through the mystery of this water and wine, may we come to share in the divinity of Christ, who humbled himself to share in our humanity. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, Fruit of the vine and work of human hands, it will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
With humble spirit and contrite heart, may we be accepted by you, O Lord, and may our sacrifice in your sight this day be pleasing to you, Lord God. Wash me, O Lord, from my iniquity, and cleanse me from my sin. Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Receive, O Lord, the offerings of our devotion, and grant that we who celebrate your Son's work of boundless charity may, through the example of the Blessed Virgin Mary, be confirmed in love of you and of our neighbor through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, to praise your mighty deeds in the exaltation of all the saints, and especially as we celebrate the memory of the Blessed Virgin Mary, to proclaim your kindness as we echo her thankful hymn of praise. For truly, even to earth's end, you have done great things and extended your abundant mercy from age to age. When you looked on the loneliness of your handmaid, you gave us, through her, the author of our salvation, your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Through him, the host of angels adores your majesty and rejoices in your presence forever. May our voices, we pray, join with theirs in one chorus of exultant praise as we acclaim,
Holy, 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 holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest.
Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Joseph, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, and Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that, by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Praise the Lord our God, for in Mary his handmaid, he has fulfilled his promise of mercy, the house of Israel. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most blessed sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot now receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you have already come, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Soul of Jesus, sanctify me. Body of Jesus, save me. Blood of Jesus, wash me. O good Jesus, hear me. Hide me within your sacred wounds. O Sacred Heart of Mary, plead for me and love me. Amen.
Let us pray. Grant to your church, O Lord, that strengthened by the power of the sacrament, she may eagerly walk in the pathways of the gospel until she reaches the blessed vision of peace, which the Virgin Mary, your lowly handmaid, already enjoys eternally in glory, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
I invite you to kneel or be seated for the litany to the Blessed Virgin Mary. The Litany of the Blessed Virgin Mary. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Jesus, hear us.
Jesus, graciously hear us.
God, the Father of heaven.
Have mercy on us.
God, the Son, Redeemer of the world.
Have mercy on us.
God, the Holy Spirit.
Have mercy on us.
Holy Trinity, one God.
Have mercy on us.
Holy Mary.
Pray for us.
Holy Mother of God.
Pray for us.
Holy Virgin of Virgins.
Pray for us.
Mother of Christ.
Pray for us.
Mother of divine grace.
Pray for us.
Mother most pure.
Pray for us.
Mother most chaste.
Pray for us.
Mother inviolate.
Pray for us.
Mother undefiled.
Pray for us.
Mother most amiable.
Pray for us.
Mother most admirable.
Pray for us.
Mother of good counsel.
Pray for us.
Mother of our Creator.
Pray for us.
Mother of our Savior.
Pray for us.
Virgin most prudent.
Pray for us.
Virgin most venerable.
Pray for us.
Virgin most renowned.
Pray for us.
Virgin most powerful.
Pray for us.
Virgin most merciful.
Pray for us.
Virgin most faithful.
Pray for us.
Mirror of justice.
Pray for us.
Seed of wisdom.
Pray for us.
Cause of our joy.
Pray for us.
Spiritual vessel.
Pray for us.
Vessel of honor.
Pray for us.
Singular vessel of devotion.
Pray for us.
Mystical rose.
Pray for us.
Tower of David.
Pray for us.
Tower of ivory.
Pray for us.
House of gold.
Pray for us.
Ark of the covenant.
Pray for us.
Gate of heaven.
Pray for us.
Morning star.
Pray for us.
Health of the sick.
Pray for us.
Refuge of sinners.
Pray for us.
Comfort to the afflicted.
Pray for us.
Help of Christians.
Pray for us.
Queen of angels.
Pray for us.
Queen of patriarchs.
Pray for us.
Queen of prophets.
Pray for us.
Queen of apostles.
Pray for us.
Queen of martyrs.
Pray for us.
Queen of confessors.
Pray for us.
Queen of virgins.
Pray for us.
Queen of all saints.
Pray for us.
Queen conceived without original sin.
Pray for us.
Queen assumed into heaven.
Pray for us.
Queen of the most holy rosary.
Pray for us.
Queen of families.
Pray for us.
Queen of peace.
Pray for us.
Lamb of God, who takes away the sins of the world,
have mercy on us.
Lamb of God, who takes away the sins of the world,
spare us, O Lord.
Lamb of God, who takes away the sins of the world,
graciously hear us, O Lord.
Lamb of God, who takes away the sins of the world,
have mercy on us.
Pray for us, O Holy Mother of God,
that we may be made worthy of the promises of Christ.
Let us pray. Grant, we beg you, O Lord God, that we, your servants, may enjoy lasting health of mind and body. And by the glorious intercession of the Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, be delivered from present sorrow and enter into the joy of eternal happiness through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Magnificat. My soul proclaims the greatness of the Lord. My spirit rejoices in God my Savior, for he has looked with favor on his lowly servant. From this day all generations will call me blessed. The Almighty has done great things for me, and holy is his name. He has mercy on those who fear him in every generation. He has shown the strength of his arm. He has scattered the proud in their conceit. He has cast down the mighty from their thrones and has lifted up the lowly. He has filled the hungry with good things, and the rich he has sent away empty. He has come to the help of his servant Israel, for he has remembered his promise of mercy, the promise he made to our fathers, to Abraham and his children forever.
Amen.
Amen. The Litany of St. Joseph. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Jesus, hear us.
Jesus, graciously hear us.
God, the Father of heaven,
have mercy on us.
God, the Son, Redeemer of the world,
have mercy on us.
God, the Holy Spirit,
have mercy on us.
Holy Trinity, one God,
have mercy on us.
Holy Mary,
pray for us.
Saint Joseph,
pray for us.
Renowned offspring of David,
pray for us.
Light of patriarchs,
pray for us.
Spouse of the Mother of God,
pray for us.
Chaste guardian of the Virgin,
pray for us.
Foster father of the Son of God,
pray for us.
Diligent protector of Christ,
pray for us.
Head of the Holy Family,
pray for us.
Joseph most just,
pray for us.
Joseph most chaste,
pray for us.
Joseph most prudent,
pray for us.
Joseph most strong,
pray for us.
Joseph most obedient,
pray for us.
Joseph most faithful,
pray for us.
Mirror of patience,
pray for us.
Lover of poverty,
pray for us.
Model of artisans,
pray for us.
Glory of home life,
pray for us.
Guardian of virgins,
pray for us.
Pillar of families,
pray for us.
Solace of the wretched,
pray for us.
Hope of the sick,
pray for us.
Patron of the dying,
pray for us.
Terror of demons,
pray for us.
Protector of Holy Church,
pray for us.
Lamb of God, who takes away the sins of the world,
spare us, O Lord.
Lamb of God, who takes away the sins of the world,
graciously hear us, O Lord.
Lamb of God, who takes away the sins of the world,
have mercy on us.
He made him the Lord of his household,
and prince over all his possessions.
Let us pray. O God, in your ineffable providence, you were pleased to choose Blessed Joseph to be the spouse of your most holy mother. Grant, we beg you, that we may be worthy to have him for our intercessor in heaven, whom on earth we venerate as our protector. You live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
Saint Joseph,
pray for us.
An act of reparation to the Sacred Heart of Jesus Christ. O Sacred Heart of Jesus, Animated with the desire to repair the outrages unceasingly offered to you, we prostrate before your throne of mercy, and in the name of all mankind pledge our love and fidelity to you. The more your mysteries are blasphemed,
the more firmly we believe them, O Sacred Heart of Jesus.
The more impiety endeavors to extinguish our hope of immortality,
the more we will trust in your heart, sole hope of mankind.
The more hearts resist your divine attractions,
the more we shall love you, O infinitely amiable Heart of Jesus.
The more unbelief attacks your divinity,
the more humbly and profoundly we shall adore it, O divine Heart of Jesus.
The more your holy laws are transgressed and ignored,
the more we shall delight to observe them, O most holy Heart of Jesus.
The more your sacraments are despised and abandoned,
the more frequently we shall receive them with love and reverence, O most generous Heart of Jesus.
The more the imitation of your virtues is neglected and forgotten,
the more we shall endeavor to practice them, O Heart, model of every virtue.
The more the devil labors to destroy souls,
the more we shall be inflamed with desire to save him, O Heart of Jesus, zealous lover of souls.
The more sin and impurity destroy the image of God in man,
the more we shall try, by purity of life, to be a living temple of the Holy Spirit, O Heart of Jesus.
The more clergy are tempted by sin and worldly allurements,
the more we shall pray for the continuing conversion, humility, and holiness of life, O Sacred Heart of Jesus.
The more souls are injured and fall away from the faith due to the corruption, crimes, and sins of the clergy,
the more we shall work for and pray for healing and justice, O Sacred Heart of Jesus.
The more your holy church is despised,
the more we will endeavor to be her faithful children, O Sweet Heart of Jesus.
The more your vicar on earth is persecuted,
the more we will pray for his continuing conversion, holiness, faithfulness, and courage, O Kingly Heart of Jesus.
O Sacred Heart, through your powerful grace, may we become your apostles in the midst of a corrupted world, and be your crown in the kingdom of heaven. Amen. Saint Michael, the Archangel, defend us in battle. Be our defense against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray. And do thou, O Prince of the heavenly hosts, by the power of God, thrust into hell Satan and all the evil spirits who prowl about the world seeking the ruin of souls. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you all, the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Let us go forth to proclaim the gospel with our lives.
Thanks be to God.
Immaculate Mary, your praises we sing. You reign now in heaven with Jesus our King. Ave, Ave, Ave Maria, Ave.